Now let us discuss the third approach to solve the problem of commutation. This is compensating windings. So to cancel the effect of MNA shift as well as flux weakening due to armature reaction, we know that armature reaction is having two types of problem. One is MNA shift and other one is flux weakening. So to cancel out these effects completely due to armature reaction, compensating windings are placed in the slot carved on the pole faces parallel to the armature conductors on the two pole faces for two pole machine, for four pole machine and so on the pole faces. Slots are cut and compensating windings are placed, and these windings are connected in series with the armature winding so as to have the polarity of the conductors of compensating winding just opposite to that of the adjacent armature conductors to cancel out the effect of armature reaction. So we can observe that for our case, this DC machine is working at DC generator. So this is direction of rotation, hence the polarity of the EMF induced in the armature conductors will be like this. And corresponding armature fluxes will have the direction shown by black line. This is cross, that's why we may get the direction of the fluxes. Here also in armature conductor dot is there, so direction will be as shown by the black dots. These compensating windings are placed in series with the armature windings. So same armature can flow between in the two conductors of armature conductor as well as the conductors of the compensating windings. So corresponding field will be, this is dot, so corresponding field will be as shown by the blue lines here also and here also. So we may observe that the effect of armature flux on field flux is completely nullified here by using compensating winding. Further, we may observe that as soon as load is increased, so the armature fluxes will increase. At the same time, fluxes produced by the compensating winding will also increase proportionally to cancel out the effect of armature flux completely. Hence, no shift in MNA will take place at any load. Whether load is more or less, MNA will not shift. So once MNA is not going to shift, that is MNA shift problem, that is sparking will not be there. At the same time, effect of armature flux is nullified on the field flux. So flux weakening will not be there. Now flux lines will not bunch up on a particular pole tip like that. That was the problem discussed during armature reaction. That will not happen today, right? No. But compensating winding will not solve the problem of inductive voltage kick, that is LDI by DT voltage. That problem will not be solved by the compensating winding. Hence, machines using compensating winding are required to use interpoles also. But this time, the burden on interpole will be reduced. Earlier, interpole has to take care of two types of induced voltages, one due to MNA shift and other due to the inductive voltage kick. But this time, the interpole has to take care of LDI by DT voltage only, because the MNA shift voltage problem has been solved with the help of compensating winding. Hence, the size is already as small. So the number of turns in that compensating winding will be smaller than the previous case, this case, right? So we can see this effect in more developed way like this. Let us make a cut from here and draw this south pole first.
Okay, let us draw. This is our South Pole. Let us make this our South Pole here. This is South Pole. Let us show this fill windings also. And North Pole here. This is North Pole and the fill windings place here dot dot. So this is our stator part. Fill windings are placed and now let us make four rotor conductors. So we know that brushes are placed along the MNA, magnetic neutral axis. So let us make those positions. So this is MNA and other MNA is this. So this is same as this. We can join two pole machine. So let us represent that brush here also, right? So mark the conductors lying under. See, in this case brushes are placed along this. So mark those conductors. So one conductor lying under this between South and North Pole. Let us make this conductor here and that conductor here. That is the same is represented here also. We have cut in from in between, right? So in between, let us represent the three conductors, armature conductors. These conductors are just for representative case, that may be any number. So mark the conductors under North Pole at this moment having these conductors polarity as those. So whenever these conductors will come under this effect, that will also have cross sign, right? But for time being, these conductors lying under South Pole are represented here, South Pole. And corresponding compensating windings are having opposite polarity as that of the armature conductors polarity. Dot dot dot. Now we are going to plot the MMF waves for both armature and field first. So let us take our axis here. Like this. Mark these points. So field MMF let us represent this field MMF again field MMF let us write here MMF we are taking MMF here, ampere turn, here take time, time is taken, so we may mark it as field MMF. Let us draw the armature MMF at the same plot. Same axis. So what about armature MMF? This is armature MMF. So starting from here, this is having its value opposite to that of the filled MMF. So filled MMF is positive here, starting from south pole. We are starting from south pole. We have make a cut from here. So starting from here. So this is positive MMF. This is negative MMF. So this one is having, armature is having opposite to that of this. So opposite to that of this means this will start from here somewhere. Make uniform straight line, right? And then we have reached till here. Then after that, this is armature fluxes are this. So armature fluxes are having opposite to that of the main field here also. So after that, both are having same. So this will be like this. So mark this as armature MMF, and we have our MMF wave shape of due to compensating winding opposite to that of armature MMF everywhere, right? So opposite to that, that can be plotted. Let us take this height equal to this, and then this height equal to this, and mark this as compensating winding MMF. So this time, if we are going to plot our MMF wave for main field, so we may observe that is unaffected. Okay. No place. So we may observe, conclude from here itself. So we may see that everywhere the armature MMF effect is getting cancelled by compensating winding MMF, right? So the net will be this one for field MMF as original one. So if we are going to plot our MMF wave shapes, just plot this field MMF or field flux. So that is not disturbed now, right? Hope it clears all the problems associated with commutation and the solutions provided to the problems with commutation with the help of these three approaches discussed today itself. Thank you very much. One more thing, we have drawn this for generator. So you may mark here this direction for generator and this direction for motoring mode. Direction of rotation of armature conductors. These are stationary part, poles, stator poles. These are moving. So for this, we can take direction for generator this way and for motor this way. Thank you very much.